Hey everyone, I hope you're all doing well this week. We had a big week on Capitol Hill this week. It started with the passage of a bill that is 2 years in the making to help our community recover from toxic algal discharges. My bill, the Harmful Algal Bloom and Hypoxia Research Control Act, it passed Congress to make federal funding available to communities that are impacted by harmful algal blooms and ensure that the continuation of a federal program aimed at combating harmful algal blooms is continued. Now, as we all know, the federal government, through the Army Corps of Engineers, has played a huge role in perpetuating the human health crisis in our community that's caused by Lake Okeechobee discharges under the auspices of flood control. And they need to take responsibility for that damage by helping to pay for the cleanup when that damage does occur. Now, even more than that, the government needs to stop prioritizing special interests over human health to put an end to this crisis once and for all. This is a bipartisan bill that will help deliver the federal resources that are needed to end this environmental disaster. It's already passed the Senate, where we worked closely with Senator Nelson to get this done, which means that it's now on the way to the president's desk to become law. We've been working hard on this issue specifically, and this specific bill for over 2 years. We started with a bill called the Federal Do No Harm Act. I think it might have been the first bill that I introduced as a member of Congress that tried to get federal disaster funding for harmful algal blooms from FEMA. Now, after some long negotiations, we were able to secure this commitment to get this program off the ground, not through FEMA, but rather through the EPA and through NOAA instead. Now, it's a big win that will have a lasting impact, with more than $100 million authorized through this bill to combat toxic algae and to help the states able to get a 50-50 cost share commitment from the federal government for clean and algae mitigation projects. So it's a big win. It's a big project for our community and algal issues around the country. Now, over the last several years, Governor Scott repeatedly requested federal assistance and declared states of emergency over these algal issues. But because the process didn't exist, Florida was repeatedly denied. This bill, it fixes that problem so that federal support can be available moving forward to prevent a repeat of what we saw this year, what we saw in 2016, and many years before that. But that's not the only progress that we made this week in the fight for the future of our community and the state of Florida. Our coalition also grew substantially as I led a group of 60 bipartisan members of Congress in urging the administration to provide full funding for programs that address toxic algal blooms and their threat to our community, to human health, to our drinking water, and to our wildlife. This goes to show that these issues, they're not issues of left and right, and they don't discriminate by geography. Toxic algal blooms affect all 50 states, and they cause several billion dollars in economic losses each and every year. We see those impacts in our community year after year after year that we don't deserve, that we don't contribute to creating. That's why it's so important to see both sides come together in this common fight, because harmful algal blooms, are such a serious issue for us in so many places around the country. We need to send this strong message to the federal government that we're not going to allow them to neglect this crisis that they themselves have helped create. Now, we keep pushing until water managers prioritize the health and safety of our community. That's one of the things that we continue to do. Until full funding is secured for the EAA reservoir, we keep pushing. Until all of these other critical infrastructure projects are completed, we keep pushing. Until pollution is stopped at the source, until we can confidently say there will be no more discharges, and until clean water flows south into the Everglades, we keep pushing and pushing and pushing and pushing. And that's what I'm up here to do. That's my commitment, is to continue to go on and push in this fight without ceasing. As always, it's an honor to represent you here in Congress. If I don't have a chance to see you before then, of course, I'm going to leave a message out there for Christmas when we get to that point, in New Year's. But I just want to say, if this is the last message you hear from me prior to that time, I hope that you have a great Christmas and a great New Year's. And I wish you all the best in this time of year and with your families and whatever travels that you may have during this time. I hope that they're safe anywhere that you're going to on a vacation or something like that. I hope that you have the best Christmas so far. All the best.